one, guys.
Over who has the best guilt. Yes. Do you have a thought on that as a Catholic, or do you think maybe everybody just has guilt? Do you feel like Catholics are more guilty than others? Do you feel guilty that you have to say that? What's the...
Yeah, that's a good question. I think guilt is a very universal feeling, but Catholics, and not only Catholics, but they feel like it's relevant. Yeah, but I think it's universal.
So are you going to do last rite, or do you go to confession? Or are you like guilty, but not guilty enough to...
No, I'm like guilty as shit.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Taxes before, man.
It's gonna be fine. They always forgive you. You just have to ask. You just say, hey, I'm sorry. Sorry, I didn't do my taxes on time. That's it. You don't even have to promise that you're gonna do them. You just have to say, I'm sorry, and they go, you know, by IRS code, I have to forgive you. I mean, look, if it makes you feel better, you can go down to the IRS and sit in like a confession booth or something.
Wait, do they have to?
To the 990, what tell you?
I had my tax forms out on my desk, but I normally submit through TurboTax, the free one, but this year I'd invested in stocks, and so they won't let you do it for free if you have stocks, at least if they were foreignly traded, which mine were. And so I didn't want to pay the $30 that TurboTax asked me to pay, because they're one of the reasons we have to independently file. How much time do you have?
A couple more minutes, but I would...
I'm sorry, forgive me, IRS, for I have sinned. I work for a 501c3, and I'm a little concerned because there's a lot of rules about the different C's, and I think there's a lot of different C's. Can you please...
Did you fill out a 501c4 instead?
I think I may have spent money inappropriately for a 501c3, but I now can't get a tax return. I just don't want to go to IRS jail, please!
Jail! IRS jail!
The fiery pits!
Hello, yes, welcome to IRS Hell. It's like regular hell. Yep, that's it. See, we have the screaming, decaying bodies here of those who filed, but they filed incorrectly, but not bad enough to be audited. But you know when you're sort of submitting and you're like, eh, I'm not gonna get audited. I don't know. And because they couldn't finish things and only made slight errors, they were like, they're only They're only like partially alive. That doesn't sound reciprocal enough or proportionate enough, but we're working on it. We're a new thing.
So I just ask, is IRS hell the same as regular hell, but just generally less enthusiastic?
I wouldn't say we're lacking in enthusiasm. I would just say we enjoy the bureaucratic side of hell, you know? That thing.
Well, the pits are pretty fiery down there. I have no interest in that. Oh, that's not fair. You can just fly? That's some bullshit, Gabriel.
I've grown bored here in tax heaven. Which we should call heaven. If we don't, it's important to specify. Anyways!
I would just assume that in heaven you don't have to do taxes. It's just, broadly speaking, there isn't a distinction.
No. No. The Father, Son, nor the Holy Spirit want to work on your taxes. And none of the angels agreed to do it. So,
Well, what if... Look, I do have my heavenly tax returns.
Do you think I'd be popular in hell? Like, do you think they'd like me down there?
I feel like you could probably just come back at any time because your lucky bastard got wings, so like...
Oh no! If you leave Tax Heaven, Tax God takes your tax wings. He takes them right away, he goes, no, no, not for you! Rips them off with a knife.
What does Tax God do if
I throw... knife.
A firing knife?
Oh, a fiery knife.
A fiery knife.
No, no firearms in heaven, none of them. So, we're like Australia.
Gabriel, if I take my heavenly tax returns and throw them into the fiery pits of tax hell, does that create a paradox?
You know, I don't know. Do it!
Hi, welcome to Tax Heaven's Tax Hell. Your tax returns.
You should. Yes.
Do it.
Yes, live adventurously. Yes.
Macadamia.
Except Joe in my office is allergic to peanuts. You would think that extends to macadamia nuts.
Let him die.
No, I shouldn't. I shouldn't be naughty. No, I guess. What about blueberry pie?
No, you want the macadamia nuts.
I really do.
Joe doesn't get to die if you get blueberry, does he?
I'm sorry, what did you say?
I'm sorry.
Are you picking up my accent? That's so cute. I didn't know shoulder devils could pick up an accent.
I tried not to bring it up. It's an accident.
Oh, the girl at the counter is staring at me.
This is the voice of Joe.
Please. Please don't poison me. I'd rather not be dead for an honest day's work.
That's very new. Sorry, Joe. Your voice coming over the internal intercom is very new. Interesting. How are you projecting now into my head?
Well, I'm just in your inner conscience. Not actually Joe. It's your idea
right.
Of Joe.
Conscience. Stop projecting. You're confusing me.
No,
just
wait,
admit it yourself.
Don't tell me to stop. I'll stop projecting Joe. No.
Shoulder devil. Can I just get rid of my concept of right and wrong simply by asking it to leave?
Here's what we need. I know there's no guns in heaven, but I want you to bring one there. You got those wings.
And this beard that I'm growing up, do you like it?
It's very pointy.
Yes. I use wax.
Listen.
Not beard wax, but candle wax. I hold it above my chin.
Well, you really do have no conscience of good or bad. Including fashion and, like, general hygiene.
No. Do you like my denim tuxedo?
Oh, no. Wow, it's a denim vest, too. It's a tie.
It's bedazzled, but only on the inside.
Okay. Do you have a denim holster? I I don't even want you to use it. I just want you to bring it there because it'll make him very upset.
Do I have a denim holster?
Wow, was that a denim pocket watch?
It what? It doesn't work.
Well, I'm out.
You what?
I'm out. I'm done. I'm not coming back. That's why I sat down, so I could tell you that and stay for a little longer. Before I ultimately am out, Denny's is not the place for me.
I want to tell you something. You're one of the best pancake flippers I've ever had.
Oh, shucks.
And I'm not just saying that.
No! Because
I say that to everybody. But I mean it this time.
Sorry, I'm going to need you to start sitting in the same booth for HR meetings. It's just we need this table.
Oh, no, I'm out. It's fine. I'm out.
Okay, can you sit in the same booth to finish the interview?
I'm going
to
be out here, so I don't think it's important that I follow your HR qualities.
Yeah, but
Okay, well then can you not hold meetings in the restaurant? Can you hold them in the office?
Can you bring me like a regular coffee? All Denny's waiters are compelled to do any Denny's related tasks if you ask them. If you ask, they have to do
something.
It has to have to do with Denny's, but you can't ask them anything.
Bring me some of those little ice cubes you have as well.
Now listen, Tom, you're a good manager, but I want to fly. I want to get out of here. I want to go see the big city. I want to go see like a bubblegum shrimp factory in Times Square. I have big dreams.
Thought you just liked torturing people at a Denny's.
Oh, there's so many more people to torture.
Go bring me the maple syrup.
Oh, and strawberry syrup.
Anything else while I'm here?
Oh, well, no, we'll get you later.
We'll get you later. Tom, I won't write. I don't want to remember you.
thought we had some.
Excuse me, you are the one who just told me that you tell everyone who you have this conversation with that they were the best pancake flipper that you've ever seen. And I'm supposed to feel bad about saying I hate you.
Yeah. It's part of my thing. Just treat people kind of weird.
Marie, quit your job.
Whoa, no! You're putting it in. Oh,
my God!